Hello and welcome back to some Let's Stream Civilization 6. We're about to get us a free settler. One way or another, it's happening. Whether we have to declare war, I'm not helping you. You're on your own. Of course, I think that spearman is just going to retreat. I think it's still our problem. Oh no, he healed. Okay, yeah. Yeah, that's the worst. So we could do this now. Or next turn. Now, we need to wait till those walls complete, and we want this guy to be a crossbow, and then we can really just deal with his horses. So we'll just wait a couple more turns. We have a lot of money. What do we want to do with it? Thinking about buying another settler. No, because we need the upgrades. Never mind. But our economy doesn't suck. So that's nice. And the spearman is the owner of that camp, so unless they spawn another swordsman, we should be okay. Want the immortal. I want to have a little bit of distribution with our military. We do have a horseman here that we're gonna have to deal with. Crap. So he's moving now. Might be time to just declare. We've got two turns till our walls. Shoot. We're out of position. We are out of position. We can instantly kill the archer and then we'll have the extra movement. Should we just do it? Next turn, we can upgrade this guy into a crossbowman. That should be enough to deal with the... Should be enough to deal with him. Azumo, thanks for the follow, man. Welcome, welcome. It would be nice to trade great people. Yeah, they need to refine the great people paths. In chat today, we're talking about Civ 5 versus Civ 6 and some of the differences and... Just kind of what's lacking. So somebody has started their great engineer points. We're still in the lead for commercial. And we have now caught up. We're not in line quite yet to take the next great scientist because other people have a massive boost. But pretty quick, we're going to have a boatload of great scientist points. So, bonus movement helps massively. Yeah. And we have four archers here. He's going to move here next. I think we want to take the shots and be able to follow up. I'm going to save it because I'm not confident in this decision. But I think we just declare war now. And then this guy might need to just go directly to one of our cities to help. I would like to complete that road at some point. All right, let's do it. Our trade deal's done. We can maybe milk another peace deal out of him. Hoi stratiotai ukomoioi tois dendrois. Hoteolindai uradios katagondai. Okay. Well, pretty defensive with those horsemen. So we don't have our bonus right now. It is bugged. That is a bit of a problem. That is a bit of a problem, guys. Oops. All right, and then our trade route expired with his allies. He's obviously hoarding up these city-states. He gets an extra culture bonus for being friends with them. We just want to make peace with all of them. Get our envoys back. Takes a turn to kick in. Okay. So we've got another traitor. We just want to be as safe as humanly possible with this guy. That might have just finished naturally. I think I want to go here. It's either that or our failed Petra City. But that already exists. Let's just go here. Although that's two food. Maybe we want the two food. Go here? What does that look like? Yeah, that's new. That's new road. Let's do it. I'm a little bit worried about it getting pillaged, though. So maybe what we do is, as much as I want the food up here, let's transfer it down here. It's just a safer... I don't want to have to rebuild my trader. We already lost one this game, so... It's a little bit worse overall to do it that way, but... All right, so...
Remember that people break down, too.
Got a crossbow there. And... another crossbow there. So that should be able to hold off these dudes without much of a problem. Now we have our extra movement. Ooh, he's got a little bit of troops to deal with. Yeah, let's make this guy an immortal too. And just between this, I think we'll be okay. That is terrifying. We need to just run away. I can't deal with that. Not with regular archers. All right, so we have machinery. Between that and a few turns of gold, I think we'll be okay. Let's go after education. Is that how you say this? I don't know how it works. I wish someone would have taught me at some point how to say words. Wheat. Let's just get our library walls and a water mill. Do you want to take down the Greeks right now? No. I just want to screw with them. I want to hinder their edumacation. Betsy DeVos told you it was edumacation. I might have lit a fire under Cry. Though I do fully enjoy his political commentary. Yeah, let's continue to save our envoys. Once we have some commercial hubs, sending them to Lisbon will make a lot of sense. But right now, they're not doing anything. And then our archer, can we move you yet? No. So we might take an attack here, but I think we'll be able to run away. Why would I found a city there? Silliness. That is silliness. So yeah, let's go ahead and get this road. We have two crossbowmen. I mean, they're going to absolutely shred this. Hopefully our walls finish before they attack. Because that might actually prevent them from finishing. The other thing we could do is send something to Lisbon so that we have a road for our cities that we want to settle over here. What do we think about that idea? No. No, and I don't want to send it all the way up here. Let's just send it here. Let's just send it there for now. Fine. No, we did lose a trade route already. Yeah, we took a lot of damage from that crossbow. Crossbows own the crap out of non-crossbows. Weird. All right. We have some semblance of defense here. Probably going to need to take advantage of our movement of these guys to maybe come back down. And then how far can the builder... The settler has the bonus movement as well. So We're able to run away from those barbs. Now they're going to keep spawning, so they are a bit of a problem, but we have our crossbows up there. Crossbows can deal with other crossbows, but... yeah. Pretty much we'll shred those, and then maybe we bring down our weaker units. Like so. Okay, so we have our camp, a couple campuses now, and a couple of them are pretty good. So I think we want to switch into the science bonus to start catching up. Again, remember, we're 10 turns behind at least where we were last game. I think we had 10 more science and probably 12 more culture last game. But we won last game convincingly, so it's not like we need to panic. Housing, we kind of need everything here. I think start with the great scientist points and get me your buildings. Hopefully by then we can buy something and lock it in, and then we'll get our trader. Our scout might be out of stuff to do. Sure.
Those who in quarrels interpose.
All right, so now these guys can fly. I love this bonus movement. We'd be screwed if it wasn't for that. But now one of our crossbows can come up and deal with his crossbow, because we're not really scared of him anymore. This doesn't kill it, so. Do we want to weaken it? How scared am I of this? Not really. Not really any. All right, let's take a look at our social policies. Conscription is still good as far as our military one. Urban planning is dated, and so are land surveyors. We want to run natural philosophy, see what that does to our science, and then we want to run serfdom for a little bit. Get some builders, make our tiles great again. It gives us 13 science. It's like a 30% boost. It's really nice. I have the bonus movement because we are Persia, and that is one of our unique abilities. We get Fall of Babylon, so plus 2 movement for the first 10 turns after declaring a surprise war. So we did that, grabbed the settler, and yeah. So that is a special ability we have. I play on standard speed. Hello, Arrow UV. How are you today? Tundra Elephants? Yeah, that doesn't really make much sense, does it? And Mizumo, if I didn't thank you for the follow, thank you for the follow. I don't want to be a dick. But sometimes I can't help it. All right, and let's continue to rush down these guys. Ooh, Valletta, chill out. Yep, that hurt a lot. Not gonna lie. That hurt a whole lot. Yeah, no problem. Persia's one of the new leaders that was in the spring update. So, no shame in not knowing what he's up to. We need to chase, actually. Can have our walls deal with this warrior. And then we need to take advantage of our movement to chase these horsemen. They're kind of running amok. And I kind of want this one. Yeah. You can go here, and these guys are close. We get to just run away again. Yep, just the CQ UI. Just the UI mod. That's the only one that I run at the moment. Oh, come on. Wuss. All right, and let's bring the settler back in here. Just that one is on loose. It also helps highlight these units that are mad at us. Boom. So we are killing his military score. We haven't lost a unit. Of course, as I say that, I probably jinx myself. So this is a battle we win because we get the first shot. And our settler can move in to the city. Yeah, we can just do that. Boom, you're dead. Can come up there. Shouldn't have many units left. This probably is one of the last ones. Good thing, too, because I think our movement's probably running out. Can go see if anything else is coming. Take cover in the woods, and we've got a decent defense because we're an immortal. Both traitors gone. Oh, no! I should have maybe just had him chill until we dealt with all his units. Yeah, that's a bit of a dick move. But we have a 5-turn builder, and we're going to get some more. In fact, we should maybe prioritize that. Still want our settler. Yeah, you get me some builders. Get a builder. And you can finish that. And then get a builder. Let's get these... get these tiles improved while we're running our serfdom. You can see our builder times are really sad. Okay. What are you building? You build another builder. No, no, no. 16 turns. Ooh, no, 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 no. Get started on my trader. This builder will help a lot, though. Move into the town so we heal. About 20 per turn in town and 5 outside your borders, so significantly better to heal inside a city. Yeah, can shoot me? Can he even shoot me? Because there's a hill in front of us. Yeah, we're good. We're good. And warrior's dead. Nice. Again, we'll just heal up in there, and then we'll have an escort for the settler. Although it can make it pretty far on its own at the moment. Can use our extra movement to move our settler. That is a cool thing that we can do. We're inside our borders, so we will still heal for 10 a turn there. Let's see if he has anything else he wants to throw at us. Probably not much. Can't really safely pillage anything, though. Love to get in there and wreck some of his things, but we will just take too much bombardment damage. Not something I'm interested in doing. And, okay, so, because the question was asked, is there a rogue horseman down south? I mean, we killed the one that was over here. I'd be sad if there was one. The question was asked, do I want to deal with the Greeks right now? And the answer is no. The reason the answer is no is I would have to build a bunch of military right now. With what we just did, we stole basically a city in the settler. And we are going to get another peace deal out of him to help our economy. You can see that we've spent a lot of money on tiles and things like that. I would have to devote a bunch of turns to building crossbowmen. We'd need a bombardment. We'd need swordsmen. We need everything to go fight him. I don't want to do that. We are finally kicking in our economy a little bit. It's turn 113. This isn't the worst. We're doing okay. And I just want to get a bunch of builders. I want to get districts in place. Turn 100 to 200, really, in my opinion, if you're not building economy, you're losing the game. Again, on deity. Specifically, I'm talking about deity. So I don't feel like dealing with that. I'm happy to mess up his curve, maybe make him produce things he doesn't want to produce, take a settler that we've been screwing with him for so long. He still only has three cities. He's also building cultural stuff. You can see that his military isn't advanced, more advanced than us. So we just want to ruin his curve, take our peace deal, and continue our economy. And then in like 100 turns, when we're kicking ass and we're like two eras ahead of him in military, we will just melt him like butter. And what are we doing here? Right. We have our settler who still has extra movement. All right. We need to then look and see where our cities are actually going. Yeah, this is helping Sousa a lot. You can see they're working all these tiles, and we're just adding production to all of them. So Sousa can finally get good. And Mercenaries is finally here, but we really wouldn't have been able to do this if we would have waited. We would have had two more crossbowmen, and that would have been great. But yeah, we really wouldn't have been able to do it, I don't think. And what do we want to lock in here? Don't have money for much. Let's just get me a builder. Just get builders. Builders, builders everywhere. Yeah, we can come over to the battlefield just in case. This crossbowman can really just do a lot of damage if we need it to. All right, we're not going by their recommendations. We're not putting any tundra cities in. Problem with the tundra is exactly what we're dealing with, is the barbs. But now that we have crossbowmen, it shouldn't be too bad. I don't hate this. We could, with a couple crossbowmen, go and take Auckland. That's a thing that we could do. Could really profit from a watermill. I mean, not really. They would get two food and one production, but I don't need food. I'm already at population 8. So watermill gives you bonuses for the rice and the wheat. It's not all farms. I wish it were all farms, but it's not. So we only have the one rice. Yeah, I'd rather them have mines and things like that. Okay, so this is a kind of filler city where it's fine, but it's not great. Where's your production come from? One hill, a couple lumber mills. It's just so underwhelming. We could go to our original capital, but again, it's the same freaking problem. Where do you put your districts? Where's your production come from? You just don't have much. And this is all grassland, not plains, so like you don't even get a base of production by working your tiles. So as much as these cities are fine, they're not good. I want good cities. I want to come down here. I think I want to do, I could do 1, 2, and maybe even a third city in there somewhere. So maybe this is priority 1. We get a bonus resource in hey Eric's, how you doing? We get a couple nice mines. There's some hidden hills within the jungle and various things. We also get to start with the bananas. So starting with bananas will let us grow. And we have nearby bananas too. Those are among the best opening tiles. Obviously, spices are better, but bananas are more common. And it might be a little greedy to try to fill in another city here. What if we settled here? Could put in an aqueduct. We would have a pretty good industrial zone. Actually, that industrial zone. No, because this would be an aqueduct. Could do a campus and an industrial zone. You'd have a 3 industrial zone and a campus. And then you could technically put in another city over here. But again, I think that's just a kind of a bummer of a city. It has a hill there, a couple hills. I mean, we could squeeze 3 in there. How wide do we want to go? Downside is the AI will take those spots. Correct. But if the AI takes those spots and we get better cities, it's a trade-off that we're just going to have to be comfortable making. Yeah, because if somebody comes over to our finds our continent, they're going to go, hey, let's put a city there. But we're just going to have to live with that. There's also these cities. We had eyed these in the beginning. Of course, Kumasai has now expanded a little bit onto one of our hills. But there are other hills and a banana. We could do a city here, or even here. It's a little bit close, though. If we did a city here, get a university, commercial hub. There's also this one. But then where do you put your districts? I think districts are too awkward if we go down here. It's part of the reason why I don't love coastal cities. I like to have the wide swath of options. We could settle a city here and then just go and wreck Kumasai and burn him down. We could do that and then settle a city. That's an option too. Well, all right. Either way, that's an option for later. So let's look at this. 2 or 3 cities, guys. What do you think? Because we could start here. That's almost just as good. So if we went there, you like 3? I think I can get down for 3. We gotta move these pins then. So if this is our anchor city so that we kind of take all the resources that we can, we don't get to start with the bananas anymore, but we get to start with the horses, and that's the same difference, right? So, try wide after our last game, which was crazy tall. All right, so I think we're coming here first. Quite a few bonus resources. Fresh water because of the lake. Theoretically, grabbing some incense, it wouldn't be a good tile at all, but it would be a luxury, and I believe a luxury that we don't have. So then, let's see, 1, 2, 3. Then do we do this with the aqueduct? I almost never build an aqueduct. If we're getting 3, I think we have to do it that way. I think we have to do a coastal. So then we would go here, maybe. And then, what about here? Here, with an aqueduct. And then this is a crazy industrial zone. And then you could put in, no, because then we get rid of the rainforest. Desert, nice place for paradises, yeah. True. Can't settle on the wonder. Get a couple nice productions. This would be a pretty high production city if we go here. What about settling on the copper? If we settled on the copper, we could get an aqueduct and a campus. But this is a really good initial tile to work. The wonder is nice for a harbor because of this. That is a pretty good harbor. It's a little bit close to this, but maybe we do it that way. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, it's tight, but it's wide, and that's the point, right? So we do this. Okay. All right, let's try it. So then this dude, I think we want to start with this one. And then this one, probably go towards the city-state first. Even though I want this city a little bit more, I think I want to snatch up their tiles. Give our borders options in expanding. Okay. Seems all right. Scout. Our scout can be useful in fog busting from here on out. Oh, and he sent a horsey. A horsey to play.
Being a mercenary, though, hey, we just go wherever there's a mixture of money and trouble.
Oh, come on. I really want to kill that. Damn. I very much want to kill that horse. If we can just ping down his military score, he's more likely to give us a favorable peace deal. Alright, we've got mercenaries now, so we can upgrade things if needed. I think I just want to grab exploration. Check in on our government one more time. I think this is fine. It's everything we want. We want serfdom. We want to make our cities better, and we want science. I don't think there's a lot better than that. We're up to... Okay, we're up to 5 envoys. The long run, we want Lisbon, because they're going to improve our gold. Our gold does suck. And they have a crappy bonus. But we are getting a couple commercial hubs, and that's sort of what we're working on next. Commercial hubs and industrial zones. We won't help our gold for a little while, but I think it's okay. Yeah, Sousa's feeling real nice. Massage those tiles. Am I at war with them? No. This is a bug. We were at war briefly, but yeah, that's just a weird bug that happens. Eat a dick. Oh, and it killed itself. That's lovely. Maybe we can pillage this trade route. I'm not really sure where it's going.
Is to replace an empty mind with an open one.
We're also sort of taking advantage of the last few turns of our government, where we get the bonus XP. So fighting a little bit right now, right before we switch, is actually kind of nice because we'll get a few extra promotions. All right, so we have education, so we have plenty of science to build into. Could go find Niter. Just to know if we have the option of going up to gunpowder and be a little bit safer. I think that's probably good. So it would at least get us a unit that we can fight with. Yeah, I don't want to risk anybody's life. That's not fun. Still rocking our extra movement. Bye, Scout. Actually, rocking this extra movement while we move is pretty nice. Is that faster? That's one turn. Yeah, I guess it is. It's about to run out, though. There you go, Sousa. You can even grow into another nice tile. You're welcome. And we need to plan their districts very, very quick here. We definitely need our traders spec. Our money blues. Part of it is that we've upgraded a few of our units, so our mortals are costing us more maintenance, and so are our crossbows. So even though we only have a couple of each, we have 6 unit expenses instead of, what, 0 prior to this war? So it's not ginormous, but it is something. Cool, just keep sending me units, brah. Really? We can't kill him. Unbelievable. Where'd that traitor go? Barbarian camp will be dealt with. So, he is willing to sue for peace. Doesn't have any gold per turn. We could take his silk instead. He actually doesn't have any great works. Is this enough? Is he willing to give me more? He's willing to give me all of his things. I mean, he doesn't have anything more to give. So I would have liked a much better peace deal, but I don't know that we're getting it. I think it's fine. Not my favorite peace deal ever, but yeah, he's just really limited, right? We can't expect him to have crazy stuff. We've limited him to 3 cities and taken his settler. So yeah. Oh, nice. Shipbuilding. And we're back to normal movement. So you can make peace 10 turns after you declare war, so it makes sense that's done. But our settlers made some nice progress. And then maybe what we do is save for one and just buy it for down here. Oh, we can't move through his borders. I guess I'll just wait to move this guy then.
Create with the heart. Build with the mind.
So much tundra. Oh, damn it. We can't move here. Hit them a mine and a farm. Keep them blocked northwest. Yeah, that's You mean northeast? This keep him here. Yeah, that's the goal. That was honestly the one nice thing about moving from here to here is that we were able to more rapidly expand northward and prevent him from settling any cities. I want the archers inside, I guess. To 61 science, not good, but not the worst. All right. Yeah, let's do all the things here. Prove all these resources, but we'll start with the mine. Oh yeah, and our the one thing there. Cool. That remains to be seen. I was being bullied to restart this game, absolutely. But we haven't won yet. We haven't won yet. But I agree that it feels significantly less worse than it did at the beginning. Okay. I think let's just start with a monument or granary for growth. Let's go that route. And then maybe we can save enough money to buy him some builders and help him grow faster. Silver plate here. I had to do a little work. It's very true. We still made good decisions last game. We turned up the pressure when we needed to, and you know, otherwise I think did a reasonable job at managing, not screwing up that amazing start. But yeah, we did have an amazing start. So, all right. I still want builders. Are you getting another builder? Get another builder. Nothing else. We can send builders down to the new cities. Trader, builder. So we'll run the builders for a little while longer. As much as that guy's strong, I don't want him to feel like he can go and kill him. Because if we lose a crossbow, our army is significantly weakened. This is a required builder. Maybe we don't need the walls then. Still just extraordinarily weak on growth. So, I don't want to buy more. Don't want to buy more tiles. Ooh, Valletta's expanded there. We could maybe... Do we destroy them? I mean, we're warmongery anyways. No one's gonna like us. We haven't even met anybody else. Do we just take our military and just get rid of them? I mean, it's silly to do that for a tile, and that's not really what I'm doing. You know, we'll want the gypsum. That's actually unique. But we could just, it also hurts him because he gets suzerain bonuses. So he's suzerain Unmet player in Kumasai. Interesting. He gets suzerain bonuses for each city-state he's suzerain of. And then, like, 5% culture? Something like that? That lets him buy stuff with faith. I think we might want to do that. One tile out of place. Oh, yeah. They are absolutely one tile out of place. I wouldn't keep them. I would melt them. I would melt them into fine powder. Do you really get the penalty if they don't know what you've done? Yeah, I believe so. I believe we do. Yeah, so we've got good production here. We need to do that. Get some farms. I think I'm just gonna get him. Well, this is this thing. Which they might be working. That'll help him grow a little bit faster. I'm gonna get him a farm over here. We'll chop that down in a sec. I think I might need to buy him that wheat tile just for a food base as well. All right, we've got a. Got a trader out back, and I want to send it to one of our new cities so that they can help grow, and they'll also expand their borders. So we're going to start here because we'll have more contested borders with Hong Kong than anything. We've only lost one tile to them. We can also wreck them if we want. All we really need is one city-state, preferably a commercial one, so that we can send international trade routes to them. Barbarians. You gotta be kidding me, man. Down here, maybe? They did ask to help with a barb camp at some point, but I can't really deal with ships. Alright. Got our industrial zone. Good. Let's certainly lock in our commercial hub as well. But I think what we want to start with is get that trader back. Let's get the trader. Builder's too long. All right, so let's look at... we need a district plan up here because they are pretty much in the realm of needing that. And I don't think we're going to be able to do a nice triangle. We have adjacent resources. Could do... Oops. That is such an interesting mode. Whoa. Does that make anybody else, like, nauseous? Like, does it give you vertigo? I feel like I have vertigo. I mean, it's actually quite elegant. I don't know that I could only play on this. But it's like flat instead of tilted, and it gives me vertigo. Whales are going to get pillaged. Yeah, it's possible. Nauseated. Sorry. Sorry about that. And you guys said you were drinking last night. That's my bad. That's not very nice of me. I think I do have to buy them this tile so that they can have a 3-food tile to work. Or I could just do a farming triangle. You should open the next bottle. Nice. Brings you back memories of Red Alert 1. Nice. Yeah. Sorry, guys. Made you dizzy. All right. That is pretty good vision. That's pretty good fog busting. Let's just have the scout chill there. And now that we actually have the fog of war eliminated over there, we can will know when the barbs spawn, at least. Don't let me see that again. Threw me way off. Sorry, buddy. That's my bad. Don't do it. Don't pillage. Okay. Let's look at our capital. Should we chop this for a district? Get rid of some of these pins now that we have them. Also, just get them a mine. Do I have to swap both? Oh, I can't have this? Oh, it's too far. Balls. Well, our capital seriously doesn't have a single straight up hill. We've got this and this. Ooh, man, that's weak. Well, one. Okay. All right, and then we want to run internal for the food and growth and also trade routes. Can go up to Susa? Go to our capital. Maybe we just start with our capital. No, we can go all the way here. So we would get a road near our capital. Oh no, through our capital and around. Oh, that's interesting. Do we care about that? I think I just want to send it here. It's also worth two food. Yeah. Good deal. Good enough. Good job, Hong Kong. Help out. Alrighty, and then these guys. Oh, we just need to buy more tiles. Can clear that, I suppose, and get their industrial zone planted. Let's do that. And in the meantime, we're just going to get another builder. We could chop for our last settler. Let's do that. They're high population, so there's not much room to grow. So this is shortened growth, so we'll just make it normal again, and then they'll grow, and yeah. It'll work out. We'll chop, get some mines, do the things. That's gonna be that. So I guess we're not too keen on chopping our woods. I was thinking about getting him a farming triangle, but we really just need the production. So I'm going to get him some lumber mills. It's something. It's not ideal, but it's going to make up for it a little bit. Do we put another one of these there? Guess maybe it doesn't. Maybe it doesn't happen yet. Let's just chop. Choppy chop chop. Gotta love chopping things. Oh, hello. Where do you think you're going? I'm just gonna ghost you.
The more science intervenes in warfare, the more will be the need for engineers in the field armies. In the late war, there were never enough sappers at any time.
So let's see. We finished Oh, niter. Do we have niter? Holy cow, are you serious? Here's some. And then here's some. Okay, so we have some. It's just not in our borders yet. It makes me feel a little bit better. And we will have a double. We'll have a double niter so that we can just hard build them. Okay. All right. Well... start with stirrups. It'll give us an option to go into gunpowder. Banking might be nice for the money from quarries. We do have several quarries, I believe. No, mostly mines. It's not that important then. Just a couple. Couple quarries. I know, man. The triangle's gonna have to go here. These are all going to be farms. All going to be farms for them. Oh well. I mean, this at least added a food to it. So getting the niter will be nice. And not, they're going to get it next turn. Okay, that's actually sweet. So we can chop, mine, and then go over here and put a mine on the niter. It's actually going to help their food base quite a bit. Screw the builder. I want you to at least plant this. And then I think I want to plant the other one too. And we'll go in that order. I can't make this a mine, though. Oh, that is in our borders. Okay, we can. All right. It's okay. Let's check in on our great people. Okay, the first engineer went... yeah, we are behind in engineers. This would be a nice one to get. Should start taking the lead in commercial hubs. And, yeah, scientists, we're going to eke out this next one, and then hopefully we'll be able to get them from there on out. Grabbing some Eurekas is a nice way to help us catch up a little bit here. University and some walls. So this guy has four charges. We're going to do one mine, clear, maybe add that. So this guy's kind of free to do what he wants. Add in another luxury if we bought that tile. Just go help with these cities. They're a little worse off. Like, how long ago did we found this city and it's still only population 3? This was our last founded city and it's 6. That's 4. It'll be good cities when they have the population, but for the time being, not so good. Yeah, and they're going to be working that right away. And then I was thinking about a farming run of farms there. Are they working this tile? They are working that tile. We didn't get pillaged. Yay. We still haven't planned this stupid thing. So let's plan. Campus. Campus. But they have a two. This could also be an industrial zone for two. Is that worth it? Or do we just put an industrial zone for one and it'll get boosted with the commercial hub? So otherwise you don't get any boosts. Unless we did commercial hub, theater square, paradise. It's improved. Is it not improved? Oh my god. Wait a minute. They're fishing boats. Fishing boats. We improved it. How dare you? How dare you, sir? It's like, I know we improved that. I know we did. But I thoroughly enjoyed your imager. If you don't do it, they can't. Okay. That's a good strategy for the future, you're saying? I can get down with that. I don't see us getting these theater squares, though. That's the problem. We can do our little paradise thing there. And there are any number of industrial zones that are just plus two. Feel like it's much more likely that this should be the industrial zone and this should be the commercial hub. I get the point otherwise, but just put like an industrial zone over there. We'll see where it goes. Hey, it's too early. It's going well, man. How are you? I don't know if we're winning or not. Does this feel like winning? I'm not sure.
All that glisters is not gold.
All right, so we have often basically
have you heard that told.
We have basically 12 turns until we can switch away from builders, so we could still get another one. Remember that we want to send some down here perhaps, or even buy them. 405. Yeah, that's pretty expensive, though. Science is up to 63. It's not great. It's not the worst. Let's swap this. Good, that added actually a little bit. And I think let's buy him a mine. I hate to keep buying tiles, especially not at a discount, but it's just we need it. We do need it. So we can put in a mine and then chop this rainforest and put a lumber mill over there. That's as much production as our capital is going to get for a while. Sort of. It's not losing at least. Yeah, I kind of agree with that. I just don't like our territory so much. All right. We can't, you can't do this. Tarsus. Grow your citizens. There, 10 turns till border growth. 6 turns till citizen growth. Do you know how much better you would be with more citizens? Oh my god, look at that. Look at this. Yeah, I know that the production time seems long, but you're going to grow, you're going to add more citizens, and they're going to work those mines.
Few inventions have been so terrible as the stirrup, but few have had so catalytic an influence on history.
All right, this dude's going to want to work this. This is a 4-build builder. I think I'm going to send him down here. And then what are we going after next? I'm still not frightened. We still outrank him as far as growth. Now, the problem is there are 4 other nations on another continent, presumably. We got the, it seems that these balance starts put 4, like 3 and 3 or 4 and 2. And obviously that kind of makes sense. But so somewhere out in the world, oh dear. Somewhere out in the world, 4 citizens are doing stuff that we don't know about. And that is not a good position to be in. So we need to be a little bit wary of what's going on. But I don't think there's anything we can do about it until we tech up. So what do we tech up with? We don't worry about Ren walls and stuff at the moment. I think we go get industrialization for the mine improvement. And then probably go up towards chemistry. It's typically the path I go for a science or military type of game. It abandons a whole lot of military tech. So let's just start with the industrialization. And we'll go from there. We can have our scout come in and help. We can do the exact same thing, and then we can do the exact same thing where we steal a settler and put a city down there. I mean, why not? The AI is dumb. That's not my fault. That's not on me. Yeah, I'm sorry, buddy, but you gotta do the same thing. You gotta work that. You gotta work that tile. You go there. You're off and running. We've got a fresh one. Can do stuff. Sweet. Another trade route, so let's send it here. They've already grown. Should have also... shit. See? Don't do that. Grow. Balls.
I cannot imagine any condition which would cause a ship to founder. Modern shipbuilding has gone beyond that.
There we go. Get some population in ya. Yummy, yummy production. Go put a lumber mill on this one. Chop that down. Do we even chop that? Do we even need a theater square? Wait a minute. To boost that? I don't know. So straight to our capital is worth 2 food. We can go to the capital and up here. I think that is a new road. We can go... Actually, yeah, this is better. Let's go here for 2 food. Zranka. Go to Zranka. Yep. Yeah, I know, Cry. I could just click the food button or whatever. But then sometimes it works stupid tiles. And sometimes I just want to lock in a what I know to be a good food base for them. So yeah, I know I can click these buttons to choose to focus on certain things. But... like this gives an extra 15 production, which is maybe what I want. Doesn't actually change anything. All right, so what are we getting now? Don't have enough population for your industrial zone. You desperately need a granary. Some walls. Hopefully by then we can get our industrial zone. Chop only saves 2 turns. Yeah. All right, and then this guy is coming all the way down here. I can hit 2 buttons simultaneously. What are you talking about? The whole thing about a button is you just push 1. Sorry there, settler. You shall not pass. Oh, you can push 2 of these buttons simultaneously? Are you kidding? Oh my god. My whole world just changed. These are more of switches? Yeah, wow. Wow, mind equals blown. Don't mind working the gold, honestly. The gold and the culture tiles, though. Wow. Can I click them all? Let's turn everything off. Don't work any tiles. Now what? Now what are you gonna do? I think default is okay most of the time. Most of the time. I guess when I settle a new city, I could just tell it, hey, food focus. Go do stuff. All right, this builder, I want to come down here. Oh no, you can swim! Oh no, they've learned how to swim. No, that's the worst. That's better. Damn. Crafty swine. You learned that from Ed Beach? I guess I don't follow his Twitter enough. Do we ever get to improve? We don't get to improve this one. Eventually. Eventually we can. Alright. Nice, and we have our extra production out of a lumber mill? Wait, why are you... Grassland? Grassland Woods? Grassland... Grassland Woods River. Why do you have an extra production? Well, that's weird. He's gonna go chop here. I guess you could just go chop there. And then I'm sure that up here we could do something useful. I am gonna want mines over here so that their industrial zone can go. Probably want that fairly soon. You can expand to the niter. No. Nope. Would like that though. The river gives production on lumber mills? I mean, I guess that makes sense. I never knew that. All right, you guys need to get started on your campus. No, no, they got back up. Damn. Should we prepare to declare war on him again and take that settler? It's a pretty fun strategy. I guess you can come down to the brand new city. Are you kidding? Stole the tech boost to rifling. Susan needs more food. Oh, they need more housing. All right. Just trying to make this so awkward. All right, you're finishing your builder and then doing the commercial hub. That's probably fine. Chop that. Chop that. It's working relatively good tiles there now. That is also all improved. These are all improved, and you still have another one you can work. You're working improved tiles. You go chop this for their industrial zone. Similarly up here, okay. This last worker has some chopping to do. Built his military up pretty quick, yeah. Yeah. It's kind of nearby, too. Oh no, he went through my archer. We're about to have capacity for some more trade routes, which will give us money, which can then upgrade our military. All right, these guys are at least connected to our empire, so that when we get our extra movement, that'll be nice. Okay, you go chop, I guess. Oh yeah, I was gonna put another one of these fancy things in. Yeah, they need amenities, but they have no improved bonus resources even, so it's largely a part of that. Really kind of wonder where he's going. Do we think about declaring on him? Can pretty much wreck this catapult. Pretty confident that one crossbowman in rough terrain can deal with these. Could also move this guy up. What districts can we lock in? I'm getting up here to clear this for the industrial zone. Are you thinking because we're going to advance eras? Moving to the Renaissance era? We're already in the Renaissance era. Oh no. Oh no, we're not. Ooh, we do need to lock in districts then. That's a good call. So, okay. Do we just straight lock them in, or do we waste? Because I don't know. I don't like wasting the production. Boy, bunch of stuff to do. So we could lock in districts in our new cities. Might be quite good. Everywhere else, I think we're fully locked in. Here, yeah. That's districts. You will soon. We could delay both of these. So we could delay advancing a little bit until we can lock in some beneficial districts. I hate to turn away from our new government. It's just for a few turns. Middle city in the north. This one can't. Yeah. Oh, can you do a second one finally? Yeah, you can. Okay. Finally, because they grew. So what do we want? Probably this over this. We're about to get a couple trade routes, so. All right, so we have builders going south. Where's the one that's going up? You. You're going there. Can lock in the industrial zone, then you can go up here. And lock in their industrial zone. And it gives time for these other ones to come down here. Yeah, we'll delay it a little bit. I think that's a good idea. We'll save our production cost by just locking in some districts.
A physician without a knowledge of astrology has no right to call himself a physician.
I feel like he's going to get this city without much of a problem. So I wonder where he's going. Okay, so this builder's here. That builder's going here, and you can go down here. And yeah, just prove some stuff, and then I guess let's district plan a wee bit. Let's do it once we settle our last city. Forbidden City's gone.
Set your course by the stars, not by the lights of every passing ship.
Alright, that gets us harbors, which will matter at some point. This is going to get boosted in a couple turns, and here's where we don't want to go quite yet. I don't see the point in getting pikemen. It's So let's do three turns into that. Okie dokie, where is this guy? Can you... Could have research a bunch, yeah. We're gonna try to do that. We'll try to take opportunities, boost opportunities here. So next turn we can buy this and lock in our industrial zone. I think that will be what we want to do. So let's sink a point into university. Here, yeah, it doesn't really matter what we chop. I'm going to do that and get an industrial zone. That locks it in for you. Let's go chop up here. All right, so this is one that we have to click those buttons. Good. Click those buttons, otherwise they're constantly going to want to work these things because there's five. Woo. Two gold and three cultures, not an opening tile you want to work. We could just lock in their harbor here. It's a pretty good district for them to get. It's going to increase their production quite a bit with the adjacent gold. I think that's fine. And then let's plan this out a little bit so that we can at least lock in one or two decent districts down here wherever possible. This was going to be our industrial zone. And could get an aqueduct. Although I think we're reasonably close to neighborhoods, are we not? Not really. Can think about an aqueduct. We don't have to worry about it right this second. That's still going to be the industrial zone. Because then we can put a... That's just too good. Then we can put a commercial hub here. Put a campus over yonder. So we could get a plus two campus, but it commits us to these things. However, we could put a campus here, and it would, we're always going to have these bananas. So it would start off as a plus two. I don't know if I like that. These are hills. Hill, hill. Hill, hill, hill. So we could just do a little... Could do, like, industrial zone. Campus. Commercial hub? Forgot about map pins, yeah. Map pins are amazing. Map pins are life. Maybe a, let's see, so we could do a campus. Commercial hub. Industrial zone. Theater square. With a unique tile improvement there. Two of them. Could also be an entertainment complex. And then we could put a commercial hub here. Or switch these. Also, how you doing, Tana? I haven't seen you one. Hope life is treating you well. We're having a lot of fun on the channel. So that's good. Should we worry more about overlap? Nah. It's okay. Yeah. Game's been crashing frequently. Oh, no. Oh, they can't be next to each other. Okay. Well, there you go. That limits it. So then we just put one there. I think I like that array. This is a decent little triangle. And what we could eventually do is put like a theater square here and a theater square there and have our unique tile improvement there. I don't think overlap matters as much on this one. Yeah, you're probably right. I mean, these cities are going to be, it's going to be a long time before they have access to these, right? So I guess in the new cities, we do want to just click those buttons. I think I like that. Those are useful buttons. At least gets us an idea. It's not the best. It's not the worst. Do we buy this so that we can start them? I do like the buttons. Thank you. I love that like people watch me and go, he doesn't know about that. Someday I'll tell him. I love that idea. Rome should be impressed with our empire. We have a lot of territory. I think we're going to lose those coastal cities. Ooh, he's got a horseman down here. That makes me nervous. All right. One more turn of castles. This guy is... he's coming. I think we'll start with their industrial zone after this. But we've already, okay, so we've locked that in. Maybe we go over here and lock in their campus. So we can chop, lock that in, and buy this tile. And chop and lock in their industrial zone. So if we declare, we can probably pretty close to instantly kill that. Does he just want to settle there? He might. But if we declare, it's a rogue horseman down here, and we have some very vulnerable builders. Do I want to mess with him anymore? Our peace deal is probably over. Doesn't matter. He gave us a lump sum. What does he even have to trade? He does have some stuff now. Rome is at 110 science. Yikes. What do you think, guys? Declare? I have to buy that tile, too. It's going to be a few turns. Oh, civil service. I think we're done with you. Go back into exploration. Castles. Warmongering's always good, Broken Lord. Yeah. It's fun to be bloodthirsty. We might lose this archer if we declare. But we could instantly kill that. We've got defenses over here. I think it's okay. I'm just worried about this one horseman. But one horseman on its own shouldn't be able to take us out, I don't think. Let's do another save. Trajan, do you want to trade anything? We have things. Do you like things? We have. Oh, you don't have much. See, he's got the stuff we want. He's on a continent like we were last time. Would you like to give us dyes and some money? How about like a little bit of money? We don't have dyes. So I think adding a luxury makes a lot of sense. Also gives us maybe points to a friendly meeting. Or the friendly meeting's probably just the hospitality thing. And then probably not going to like us so much when we declare. He's also kind of a boss right now. He's 125 culture per turn. He has 9 cities. We have 9 cities, technically. We also have our little scout here. All right, let's do it. I started like 3 hours ago, I think, quickie today. What up, Zach? How you doing, man? Yeah, I need the uptime command. All right. Ooh, we're not going to be able to instant kill that horseman, though. Can do this. All right, let's peace out the city-states. Yikes. Nope, we're friends again. Nope. Still friends. Okay. Okay, deal. Yeah, I was a little late getting started today, quickie. Usually I like to start around 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. But I had to help my brother move a couch because I am a good person. And then we had a couple shots over here. Let's take them. Yep. Okay. See what trouble we got into here. Ow. Got more horsemen. Oh, Rome. Instantly like, hey, this is my continent now. Okay, we've got some walls to help us this time around, though. Move back and still fire. That was a successful round, and then we can actually move up and shoot some things. How have some of the battle mechanics changed from Civ 5 to Civ 6? Even if my brother makes you wonder if we have the same parents? I don't understand that. So battle mechanics. One of the major mechanics that changed that affects war times are movement. So typically in this game, if you have two movement, you can move two tiles. Moving into a rough terrain tile in this game expends all your movement. So you can no longer go start here and go 1, 2. You could do that in Civ 5. In this game, you can't. You have to be butted up against your rough terrain and use your full movement to get there. So that actually changes a whole lot, especially in the beginning of the game and as far as fighting wars, because you're not as mobile. So you have to carefully consider your terrain significantly. Wall mechanics have changed some. You can't. They started off where you could buy walls. You cannot buy walls anymore. Otherwise, they're pretty similar. They kept one unit per tile. I think you have more of an advantage defending in this game than even in Civ 5. You always have an advantage defending, but it seems more profound in this particular game. Did we get pillaged again? No, we just have more trade routes. Holy run-on sentence, Batman. Dude, I am king of run-on sentences. You're welcome. There was probably a period or a comma in there. I don't know. Don't worry about it. Are we scared? He's got a better military than us. I'm more scared for this guy. Oh yeah. Insta-complete those walls. Now I'm less scared. I'm barely scared at all. All right, so let's lock in our districts. We've got two turns until we advance eras. So this guy needs to go here and do a chopperoo. And then we can lock in the campus. And I think we might just want to start with the walls. Crossbowman as a promotion. Darn right. Dude's a boss.
Oh.
Quickie, I felt like my explanation of battle mechanics changing was also a gigantic run-on sentence, so don't feel bad. All right, I think we need to get our... maybe getting walls and then some of these things. Get our great people points going. No. Click this button. So Rome is the one with the great engineers. That sucks. I would really like to get that. We are now working towards great merchants, and we are still at the top of the list for great scientists, though we lost another one. Someone must have bought it, because I think we were supposed to be in the lead there. Oh, and he moved. Can we do this? Ha! Got it! And our crossbowman is in the front. Perfect. Alright, so we're locked in there. We've got all of our districts locked in. Technically lock in a second one here. I think can we move and do that? Yeah, because we have extra movement, so we can move, chop again, lock in our commercial hub before we advance ages so that we have our production costs as low as possible. And then, are you locked in everywhere? No. But you also don't suck. So maybe locking in there isn't as big of a deal. Here is where we want to do it, though. 180? Son of a. You're not really going to be able to lock that one in. Barb camp on the top left city. Where? Oh, nice.
Gracias. Ellis, we are using a CQ UI. It's just a UI mod. You can do that to figure it out.
That's the only one. It doesn't change the gameplay at all. It just gives us extra visuals. Having the leaders here with their like science and mouse over tons of information is very, very nice. Really, really nice to have. All right, next turn. Okay, a little bit of damage.
Doing okay. What are my plans towards Trajan?
Why do I need plans? I'm just going to ignore him. He's not a problem. It's certainly not a problem. Yeah, that last game was a god spawn. If anybody wants to see a total straight up god spawn, go to my YouTube and watch the Cleopatra, at least the first opening video. Because it was pretty much spawn of a lifetime. And we rolled Brazil early, and it was just the best game we've ever played, I think. So if you're interested, check that out. That's right over there on the YouTubes. All right, and we're going to chop for them. Oh, yeah. Save that one turn on the harbor. God, I'm good at this game. So we're going to grow there in 13 turns. We're not going to be able to lock in these other districts. I don't have money to do so. So these guys can go over here. I could have also swum around. Swam. And then we need, I guess, one of our weaker coastal cities. It's that or over here. Not sure which is better. Let's make sure that we can kill things, even though we have promotions. You can just heal. That's perfectly acceptable. Die. Also die. Damn. All right, so we have to use... Oh, that's a hill. We can't actually shoot there. So we have to go here. Shoot. Here. Shoot. And, yeah, let's just do as much damage as possible. Sneaky Roman say, I know, cry. He, like, showed up. He's like, howdy. Found. And he's also, based on the look of this city... further ahead than us. We are still in this. We look sad. All right. We need traders, I guess. Where's the city going? Here? It's just not good. It's just not a good city. Is this better? Exposes more water, which I don't like. But we still get that hill, and then we pick up a couple extra production tiles in the deer and the stone. Gonna have to rely on a couple lumber mills. Yeah, I don't think squeezing in two cities over here makes sense, so I think it just goes here. Do I prefer Civ 5 or Civ 6 so far? Pretty settled in the original spawn location. Wah, wah. I think we just come down here and do one coastal city. I like Civ 6, honestly. It's a really fun game. I think it has a little bit of time left to get some polish on it, but in general, I like a lot of the mechanics. I've love the civics tree, love the tech tree, although they need some tweaking as well. But I like the idea of the civics tree as opposed to just the social policies of Civ 5. And then I really like the way that the government works. This is really how you manipulate and min-max and have success in this game. And I like the various governments with the legacy bonuses. I think those changes alone make Civ 6 worth playing over Civ 5. So can move there and still chop. Perfect. And then let's lock in their commercial hub as well. Boop. Nope. All the way up. There we go. Now it's locked in. 6 citizens already there. 3 and 1. Eef. Let's see what he does. He's got a couple more units. Ow. Ow. Not so ow. Boom. Renaissance era. So district production costs have increased. Are we going to lose this dude? I'm moving the scout for a flanking bonus. And I'll bring this other guy up just in case. We have our new government, so we get to run Merchant Republic now. Just going to give us 2 extra trade routes, which we need to take advantage of because our money is kind of bad. And we get more policies. We didn't micro those very well, did we? All right. What do we want to run? Housing's not much of an issue. We don't have particularly tall cities, so Medina Quarter doesn't seem good. Caravanseries would be nice because we're going to probably still run a few internal trade routes, and this will at least give us some gold, which makes trade confederation worse because they're going to be internal trade routes. So we might be able to just run some scientist points. And what else? Aesthetics doesn't do anything right now. We don't have any theater squares, and even if we did, theater square bonuses are hard to come by. So doubling zero is still zero. We could run limes to produce walls. I may do that at some point. Don't have a lot of good options. We need more policies.
Confused by the districts at first, yeah.
Cool, I'll go over the districts. I'll go over the districts. Let me finish this and we'll put a pause in the YouTube vids and I'll come back and we'll begin with some district discussion. Limes? It's limes. That's spelled limes. You can't shame me for that. You like the housing? I mean, maybe we do need it. We do have a couple of bigger cities. I think that'd be better than anything. I think you're right. We have a couple big cities and these other ones are kind of getting there. Yeah, it'll help like 4 of our cities. So I guess that is worth. All right, let's put a cut in the video there, and then at the beginning of the next, we will start talking about some districts. Thanks for watching, guys.